meaning and definitions, and today lecture discuss the importance of capital structure. This is a discuss the last lectures, and today lecture discuss the factors determining capital structure. So the factors determining capital structure, which is a factor determining capital structures. First one is risk of cash insolvency. Topic name is factor determining capital structure. Factor determining capital structure. Factor determining capital structure. So the first one is risk of cash insolvency. Risk of cash insolvency. Risk of cash insolvency. So the risk of cash insolvency. So the risk of cash insolvency. First one is risk of cash insolvency arises due to failure to pay fees. Fixed interest liability. Risk of cash insolvency means risk of cash insolvency arises due to failure to pay fixed interest liability. Generally, the higher proportions of debt in capital structures compels the company to pay higher rate of interest on debt, irrespective of the facts that the fund is available or not. This is a risk of cash insolvency means failure arises due to failure to pay fixed interest on liability. Generally, the higher proportions of debt in capital structures compel the company to pay higher rate of interest on debt, irrespectively of the fact that the fund is available or not. This is the first one is cash or cash insolvency. Cash risk of cash insolvency means the non-payment of interest, charge, and principal amount on time may lead to liquidations of the company. The sudden withdrawal of debt fund from the company can cause cash insolvency. This risk factors has an important bearing in determining the capital structures of a company, and it can be avoided if the project is financed by issue of equity shares capital. This is a risk of cash insolvency. And second one, so the risk in variations of earning. Risk in variations of earning. Second one, risk in variation of earning. Variations of earning. So this is variations of the earning. In this way, the higher the debt content in the capital structures of a company. This is the content is the higher debt content, the capital structures of company, and the higher will be risk is variation is the expected earning available to equity shareholder. If return on investment on total capital employed, that is total capital employed, so the total capital employed shareholder fund plus long term debt, this is the exercise the interest rate, the shareholder get a higher return on the other hand, if interest rate exceeds return of on investment, the shareholder may not get any return at all. May not get any return at all. This is the third one is cost of capital. So the third one, cost of capital. Cost of capital means cost of raising the capital from different source of fund. Cost of capital means from the raising different source of fund. It is the price paid for using the capital. Price paid for using the capital, and business enterprise should generate enough revenue to meet its cost of capital and finance its future growth. The finance manager should consider the cost of each source of fund while designing the capital structures of company. This is the cost of capital means. Cost of capital means cost of raising the capital from different source of fund. That is cost of capital. Second one, last one is control. Last one is control. For the control. In this point, the considerations of retaining control of the business is an important factor in capital structure decisions. Control means this is the considerations of retained control. Retaining control of the business is an important factor in capital structure decisions. This is the important control का important factor कौन सा है? This is the capital structure. This is the if the existing equity shareholder do not like to dilute the control, they may be prefer debt capital to equity capital as former has no voting right. This is the control. Okay, and next one is component of capital structure. So the component of capital structure. Component of capital structure. Component of capital structure. Here, component of capital structure. So the component of capital structure. Component of capital structure. In this point, the decisions of designing the capital structures become more complicated as various options are available to raise fund, and each option has its own distinct features. This is the first one is decision to design the capital structure become more complicated as various options are available to raise fund, and each option has its own distinct features. Hence a firm has to take decisions of proportions of equity and debt after considering its implications of financial performance of the firm and on the interest of all stakeholders. Therefore, the most circular decisions for any company in the formation of the appropriate capital structures. The optimum capital structures of a company helps the management to achieve its ultimate objective of minimization overall cost of capital and maximization profitability, earning per share and market value of the firm. This is a component of capital structures. So the component of capital structures, optimum capital structures of company help the management to achieve the ultimate objective of minimization overall cost of capital and maximization profitability. minimizations overall cost of capital and maximizations profitability, earning per share and market value of the firm. This is the main functions of component and capital structures. So the next functions, component, excessive use of debt affect the survival of the corporate firm, whereas a conservative policy depresses the firm from achieving maximization rate of return to shareholders. Next one, the capital structure is the mixtures of debt and equity. Capital structures already discussed केलेले आहे कालच्या लेक्चरला. आपण कॅपिटल स्ट्रक्चर कसे होतं, डेट प्लस इक्विटी इज इक्वल टू कॅपिटल स्ट्रक्चर अँड इट्स मिक्सचर डिसाइड द ओव्हरऑल कॉस्ट ऑफ कॅपिटल व्हिच लीड द फर्म टुवर्ड ऑप्टिमम कॅपिटल स्ट्रक्चर. द मेन कंपोनेंट ऑफ कॅपिटल स्ट्रक्चर आर इक्विटी अँड डेट. मेन कंपोनेंट ऑफ कॅपिटल स्ट्रक्चर आर इक्विटी अँड डेट. दिस इज अ हायलाइट वन. Main component of capital structures, equity and debts. Okay. Other factors which are closely associated with the decisions of capital structures are operating leverage, financial leverage, earning per share, in short EPS. Okay. Return of equity, in short ROE, cost of equity, cost of debt and overall cost of capital. Equity refers to the owner's stake in the business in a company. From business organization, the shareholders are the real owners. Therefore, monetary value of right of shareholder in the company is known as equity. Hence, equity include equity share capital, preference share capital, and retained earning. Equity is also called as net worth. Thus, debt is purely a financial obligation for a company which has to serve obligatory in terms of payment of interest as well as the redemptions of principal amount as per the term and conditions of borrowing agreement. Okay, today's point is over. Component of capital structures and next discussed in next lectures. The component of capital structures are discussed in following sections: earning per share, return on equity means ROE, earning per share the formula is EPS is equal to profit for equity shareholder divided by number of equity shares, and ROE, this is the formula, is ROE is equal to profit for equity shareholder divided by paid up equity capital shareholder. This is discussed next lectures, and today's point is over. Thank you for all of you, and thank you for everyone.